Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. I know some of you would have been wondering where have I been, all this well. Well, I've been on that earth, but life has been hard. Today I have a guest on my channel. By now you should have figured out that his name is Daniel Emichite. Did I say yeah? Please subscribe. Well, let me go back to that. Subscribe, please. Not subscribe to my channel. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you. So I have a guest here with me, Daniel Emichite. He was my classmate in secondary school, an engineering student, and he's currently here in Lagos with IT. So I decided to bring him to my channel for us to discuss stuff. So enlightening stuff, yeah. So Daniel, please introduce yourself to my subscribers.
Hello, guys. I'm Daniel Emichite. I'm currently in telecom space. And basically, I'm not here to share my experience with you guys. I finally got what I wanted and share some advice for people who are currently looking to work.
Okay, so the number one question here for Daniel is that why did you choose engineering? What course? Why did you study marketing, photography, vlogging? Why engineering?
Okay, I chose engineering because I felt like I could fit school. Yeah,
okay.
And I had that passion for mathematics. So I felt engineering was where I could explore my skills in mathematics. So that's why I chose.
Alright. So the second question, still I have to wait for my phone, I can't grab all the questions on my head. So the second question is does it believe or do you believe everyone can do well in professional jobs? Like, do you think I can read medicine, I can read engineering and do well in it?
I think everyone should have a passion for whatever they want to do. You always do better when you know what you can do.
Yeah, you enjoy and have a passion for it.
Yeah, because when you get tougher, it's only that passion that will keep you going.
Yeah,
so I think everyone should have passion for whatever they want.
Next question I have here was, does it take talent to succeed in any professional career? I guess that passion and talent goes alongside. So if you don't have the talent, you don't have the passion, you can't really, it's going to be difficult, but it's still possible.
From the aspect of being in school, you can still, if you are really determined and willing to learn, you can still, even when you don't have a passion, you can still graduate and learn from other people. Working in a work, when you come to the work, it's a totally different thing. You need a passion to succeed in your professional life, especially if you are working in a work, if you are working in a work, you just have to be doing it. Because you have to, when I work, you have to be different. You have to be from this, there are such mathematics and engineering. But everyone has that common goal of learning what the industry is willing to do and trying to deliver. Yeah, so everyone just wants to learn. So no matter what you're studying in school, when it comes to business, you just have to do it.
Okay, so the next question is your biggest fear in this career?
Yeah, currently, I really don't have a fear in my career because I don't plan ahead.
You should like to plan ahead.
Yeah, yeah. I must have
plan A, plan B, plan C, plan D, plan E, plan F. So if one does not work, just not like just move to go.
That's
the best. So unemployment issue in Nigeria, how do you think that affects us? Because I think it affects us in the world. What do you think? Do you think like we need to realize say
everyone has to be this unemployment stuff because but mostly we have to be in the government because the responsibility is 80% of the resources like and then private investors. Yeah, but sometimes you see most graduates at the school don't really have much. Yeah, so we might want to focus on our schools for more employees. But then on the other side, if you look at what is happening all over the world, so basically, unemployment rates in Nigeria might not be as bad as it is in many other advanced countries. We still have almost the same just like you have to continue doing what you love, continue applying for that, continue networking with people.
So what's your advice to we, the entrepreneurs, the upcoming entrepreneurs, professionals who at some point get tired? I know you're not a perfect Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.